you can win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Chevrolet Camaro. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Gene. Welcome, everybody, to Card Sharks. You know, I am the host of this show, but I've kind of decided, I think, Gene, make a note of this, please. I'm to be referred to as host and quiz master. I like that. Host and quiz master. It has a ring to it. Anyway, we've got a brand new Z28 that we want to give away, plus tons of cash. So I want to get started right away, and I'd like to meet our dealers. Here they come right now, our lovely dealers. And they are Susanna Williams and Lacey Pemberton. Here they come. You like quiz master? Quiz master. That's my new title. Quiz master. It's what I want to be known as. Host and quiz master.
Interesting.
You like that?
Interesting.
How about Cuisinart? You think Cuisinart would be good? Would you deal out the cards?
Yes.
It's time for us to meet our card sharks. Come on out. Hello, Lynn.
Hi, Bill.
Here's Lynn. She's got a little 9-month old boy sitting at home now, right?
Steven.
Steven,
yeah.
Huh? Steven's 9 months old, and you guys are in the midst of what house? I think you told me you were looking for a house.
Yeah, my husband and I are looking for a house, and with the money I just won, it'd help a lot,
Yes, indeed. Yeah, hopefully you'll get a nice down payment down for the house. Who knows how much money you can win, because already, to date, cash and prizes totaling $4,220.
Yeah. Yes, a lot of money.
And here is our challenger, Jack. Hello, Jack.
Hi, Bill. Jack Ferguson, still retired from the government, living in a beautiful Hot Springs, Arkansas.
And that is a nice place. Yes, indeed. You're now aren't you in the hotel business now or something? Or you said you
I can't name it, can I? Elizabeth Taylor's first husband.
Elizabeth Taylor's first husband. Diamond. He's in the Diamond Hotel business. Anyway. All right, good luck to you, Jack. Both of you guys have cut your cards backstage. Of course, we always add prize cards. And when they show up, who knows what's gonna happen. It gets real exciting around here, but there is a trip to the Bahamas, and they're worth about $3,000. Let's get started right now. We're in the middle of our first game, heading for our third question. Lacey's already dealt out the cards, and this question is for Lynn. We surveyed 100 married women, and we asked them, do you think you have a better marriage than your parents did?
That's
an interesting question. I like this question.
That's a good
question. How many
question.
Married women said they do have a better marriage than their parents?
I think a lot of women would agree that their marriages nowadays, everybody tries, they really do right now. I'd say it's a high number of about 50.
A high number of about 50? What do you think, Jack?
The younger generations think they're undertrod or what have you, that mother had it best. I think that's a lower number.
You're going with lower.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm going to agree with you. I'm going to agree with Jack. I think it's a case of the grass is always greener, too. Everybody thinks everybody else is doing real well. The actual number of married women who said they have a better marriage than their parents is 74. It is not lower, it is higher. So, Jack, you and I are wrong, and the champ goes to the board.
What do you want
to
do with that? Can I please change the card?
Sure you can.
Good.
10 now becomes
a
Jack.
All right, let's go lower.
Lower than a Jack? We've got a 3.
Let's go higher, Bill. Higher.
Higher than a 3. One of our prize cards shows up. We've got a refrigerator. Suzanne will be putting that on Lynn's side of the board. And let's replace that card right now. And we're
I'd still like to go higher,
please. Higher than a 3, she says. We've got a 7.
May I freeze?
Like to freeze. It's up to you. You want to freeze, you freeze. So, Lynn freezes on that side of the board, keeps Jack away from it. And now, we are due with our final question, and that means it is sudden death. Somebody's got to win the game on this next play of the cards, and we're about to ask our audience poll question. We have visiting us this week 10 former Playboy bunnies. Here they come. Ah, yes. Here these young ladies are. Now, Jack, this question is for you. Before the show, we asked these 10 former bunnies, I don't know how we had the nerve to ask this question. Have you ever played strip poker with a date? How many of these 10 women admitted they have played strip poker?
Lovely people, all of them. And they're smart people. I think they would start with more clothes than what they have on now. Maybe 3 of them have played strip poker.
You're going with 3.
3.
Mm-hmm. Lynn, what do you think, higher or lower?
I think it's a... Let's see. Let's go higher, only because I know one of them, at least sometime in their lifetime, has played strip poker.
So you're going with
a little higher. Little higher.
Should I question your dating habits?
Yeah, I played.
Oh, love
and
it.
And I won, too.
And you won? Well, that was nice to hear. The actual number of these women who have played strip poker is 3. Right on the money. Yeah, all right, I'm coming. Jack gets it right on the head, and that means Jack gets $100.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Bill.
For purposes of research only, ladies, the guys on the crew just wanted to know who were the 3 young ladies who played this game. Raise your hands. Corey, Maria, and...
Corina.
Well, Maria, you're down front. You're closer to the microphone. What, any tales we can share with most of America about this?
With most of... Well, I was suckered into it. It's okay. We were playing cards, and he likes to gamble, and so I was winning a lot, and he said, well, let's play for something a little more important. So I was suckered into it, and...
Suckered into it. I guess you raised him $5, and he said, how about my pants?
Anyway.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Have a seat, young ladies. We're going to be right on here. Here you are, Jack. What are you going to do?
Change it, Bill.
Change that 9. That 9 now become... Oh, wait a second. Let's put this back.
Uh-oh.
Okay, Jack, here's the situation you've got to face right now. It is now sudden death. What do you want to do? You want to play or pass?
With her luck, change it, Bill.
You're going to change it and go on. All right. He makes the decision. We're going to change the 9. Let me have a card for Jack over here. That 9 now becomes a 6.
I'll go higher. Go
Remember,
higher.
If you make a mistake, she's automatically the winner. Mm-hmm. He's going higher than a 6. We've got a 9.
There's no more freezing. Lower.
He goes lower than a 9 for game number 1. No! And that means that Lynn wins it. Very good. Well, I think you made the right decision. Lynn has 1 game on her side of the board. When we come back after this commercial message, we're going to have game 2. They're already setting up for it. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Here we are. We're about ready to play game number 2. The champ has 1 game on her side of the board, and she is 1 step closer to the refrigerator. That's the prize she has on her side of the board. Remember, whoever wins the match, they go on to the money cards. Let's get started right now. Lacey's already dealt them out. First question goes to Lynn. Educated guess, Lynn. Think about it. According to the World Book, in miles per hour, how fast can a housefly fly?
I haven't timed one lately.
there he goes.
It's hard to catch him. Let's go 5 miles per hour.
You're going 5 miles per
hour? Sure.
What do you think, Jack? Is it higher or lower?
Bill, I played with June bugs in my time on a string. I think that fly can fly fly a little faster.
That fly, you say that 3 times fast. That fly can fly
a little faster. I can't.
Okay, we got a higher one from Lynn's 5-mile-per-hour prediction. The actual number of miles per hour a house fly can fly is 5. Right on the head. Very good play. You know that this is the 3rd trip I made over here?
Yeah.
The first 2 where you got on the audience poll, those were 100 apiece. And for getting this one right, you're going to get $500.
Are you serious?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. $500. There it is. Here we go, Lynn. Take a look at the board. Tell me what you want to do here. You've got a king.
Oh, let's go lower. Let's go
lower.
She goes
lower than a king, a 10.
Let's go lower again.
Lower than a 10, a jack.
Yeah, that's okay.
So we go rack here, and Jack said it. He gets a freebie. Let's take a look at the card. You got an 8.
I'll go higher.
Than an 8. He's got a king.
Lower, Bill.
Lower than a king. A queen.
Lower, Bill.
Lower than a queen. A 10.
Freeze it, Bill. Freeze it on a 10. Freeze it.
Freezes on a 10. Listen, his cards, he does what he wants. But the strategy here is he wants to change the 10, and if he gets this question right, he can change it and get the card he wants. Here's the question, and it goes to you, Jack. We surveyed 100 fourth grade boys, and we asked them, if you could snap your fingers and magically have either a pet pony or a pretty girlfriend, would you choose the pony? How many fourth grade boys would choose the pony?
Fourth grade boys aren't too smart, Bill. I think they'd take the, let's see, about 73 of them would take the pony.
You're going with the pony. Mm-hmm. What do you think, Lynn?
Gosh, I'm gonna say higher.
You're gonna go higher.
Just a little higher, because fourth grade boys don't know about women yet.
Neither do 40-year-old men, for that matter, but that's another story. The actual number of fourth grade boys who would choose the pony is 20. It isn't higher, it is lower. That is interesting. That is a very interesting statistic. I would have went with the pony myself, but that shows you what kind of life I've led. Anyway, Jack, let's take a look here. Jack, what do you want to do?
Let Lacey turn me up a 2 there.
You want a 2? Well, Lacey, the man wants a 2. Let's take it for him. Will this 10 be a 2? An ace it will be.
That's good enough, Lacey. Good enough. Lower, Bill.
He goes lower than an ace to tie it up. He's got it.
Psycho.
We've got a tie. That means we'll meet you back after this message. We're going to have the tiebreaker. Stick around. We'll be right back. Tiebreaker. Each of the contestants have won one game. Real important game coming up right now. Suzanne and Lacey are setting it up. 3-card game. Maximum of 3 questions. And here is our first question, and it goes to Lynn. And again, it is our audience poll question involving 10 Playboy bunnies. Here they come. Getting into place over there. Lynn.
Yes.
Before the show, we asked these 10 former bunnies, have you kept count of how many men you have conquered? How many of these 10 women have kept count?
That's personal. Gosh, I don't think anybody really keeps count, because it's just not something you keep notches in your bedpost with. You know, I just don't do things like that. It's a low number. Let's say about 4.
You're going 4. What do you think, Jack, higher or lower?
Bill, I'm a winner just to get to look at these girls another time. No. Mm-mm. Lower, Bill.
You're going lower.
Lower. Mm-hmm.
You're going lower. Could be broken hearts here. We may be putting the wrong slant on this. This could be just a love affair. That's all. The actual number of these women who have kept count is 2. It is lower. Jack's got it right. Which of the 2 late Maria? We learned so much about you in this show. Maria and Ruth. And Ruth, you keep count?
Yeah, I do, because on lonely, boring nights, it gives me something to do to occupy my time.
Maybe you could try paint by numbers or something like that. Listen, thank you very much, ladies. Have a seat over there. Let's go to the board. Jack. You got a 4. What do you want to do?
Good number. I'll go higher.
He goes higher than a 4. Remember, this is the tiebreaker.
Run the board.
He's going higher than a 4. A 9.
Go down.
He's going lower.
Lower.
He's going lower than a 9 for the game, the match, and the color TV. He's got it. Way to do it.
You got the money.
Well, thank you so much for being here, Lynn.
Thank you.
Good luck with you and your husband and little Steven.
Thanks.
And I hope you got enough money for that down payment on the house.
You've
got $4,720 cash and prizes.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for being here. Come on over here, Jack.
Thank you.
Come on over. Good luck to you. So stand right next to me over here. Now, Gene Wood. Well, we will. I hope we do ourselves. Gene Wood, why don't you tell Jack what he's won?
Okay, Bill. Jack, you have won virtually all-screen 25-inch remote control Zenith Color TV with Chroma Color Picture Tube, 178-channel capability from Zenith. Congratulations, Jack.
Oh, good. Thank you so much, Gene. We're going to go on right now to play the money cards. Here comes Suzanne and Lacey. They're going to deal those cards out for Jack. I have a feeling Jack's an old card man from way back. I know how he knows how to play those money cards. But don't forget now, Jack, in addition to all the money you can win, we've added a joker to the deck. Anytime it turns up in the money card, you will have an opportunity to win this brand new car. Gene.
It's the Chevrolet Camaro Z28 IROC. Features IROC option, package 1, T-top, fog lamp, automatic transmission, aluminum wheels, and AM/FM ETR stereo radio from Chevrolet, worth over $16,000.
16 grand. All right, come on over here. Stand up here, Jackson, and get a good look at the car. Now, for winning our match, we're going to guarantee you a shot at the car, because we're going to give you an extra joker that Lacey's holding on to right over there. So you know you're going to go to that board at least one time. Now let's get Jack started here. Let's give him $200. Come on, Jack, play the cards.
Turn it up.
Here's your base card, sir. You got a 9.
Oh, a 9. Change it.
Pick the one.
Number 3.
Takes number three. Let's get some cards up here for Jack. That nine now becomes a four.
Okay.
$200 on a four.
$100 higher.
You're going $100 higher than a four. If it's another four, no win, no loss. It's a push.
Good deal.
$100 higher. You got it.
That's a good one.
$300 on a queen.
$200 lower.
$200 lower than a queen. A 10.
Hey, that's a good one.
$500 on a 10.
$100 lower.
It's going $100 lower than a 10. No.
Hey.
So, good bet for Jack. Jack loses $100.
Okay.
He's now got $400. We're going to take you up to the second level here. Jack, give you $400 more. You've got $800 on a Jack.
$200 lower.
$200 lower than a Jack. A four. $1,000 on a four.
$500 higher.
$500. $500 higher than a four. An ace.
Oh.
$1,500 on an ace.
All of it lower, Bill. All of it lower.
Yeah.
Oh,
$3,000. All right, Jack, you got $3,000, and you're playing off an eight.
Susanna, put number two up there.
Let's get him a card now. Remember, he's got to wager at least half his winnings on this card.
Two.
An eight!
Hey, hey, hey.
$3,000.
All of it lower, Bill.
All right, Jack.
I love it.
It's either it's $3,000 or $6,000.
I'll trade you for the card.
No, for $6,000, here it comes. You got it! Good for you. You've got $6,000. $6,000. That is just
lovely.
Very good. Started off a little slow, but he's got $6,000. Total of $6,690. Don't forget about the Joker. When we come back, he's going to try and get the call. We'll be right back. Waiting for you. I'm glad you got back to it, because Jack, who now has $6,690 in his pocket. He's a happy winner. He's our champ. He has the opportunity now to try and win that brand new Z28, which is sitting back there. Here is the Joker that we promised him when he started the money cards. Here is your Joker, Jack. Let me tell you how you're going to do it. Behind one of those numbered cards is the word car. You find it with that Joker. We're going to give you that car. Go find it for me. Come on.
Well, it's behind number three.
He's saying behind number three. Playing a hunch or
I'm just, psycho.
He's
psychic.
No,
psychic.
He's psychic. Okay. Let's take a look. If the word car is here, he's gonna be real happy. No! No, what is that? You
another
said
game,
number three.
Another game.
You said number three, you know where it was? Right here behind number two. You were right next to it.
Can't
anyway,
win them all.
Yeah, you can. And if you win this next match, you could be right back here for the car again. Let's get started right
I
now.
Keep meeting us.
Go over there, let's meet Kim. Come on, Kim. Here she comes. Hello, Kim.
Hi, how are you, Bill?
Tell the folks at home something about yourself, please.
My name is Kim Elliott, and I'm engaged to be married on New Year's Eve.
Engaged to be married
engaged
on New Year's Eve?
Engaged to be married on New Year's
Ooh,
Eve.
Ooh, go ahead, flash that diamond out there. Let everybody, yeah. What a nice guy. You've already cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I have.
Well, good luck to you. Now,
Thank
I want
you.
To remind you about our prize cards. We have in there a trip to Tahiti.
Woo.
Ooh, I like that. And a Quasar camera is in there. Let's get started right now. Lacey's dealing out the cards for game number one. First question goes to Jack. Jack, educated guess. Got to think about this one.
Swag it.
If you wanted to make a direct dial telephone call from New York to Paris, how many numbers would you have to dial?
How about dialing one for help? Zero. No, I need to complete the call, right?
You're going to direct dial to Paris, and you have to complete the call, yeah.
11 numbers.
You're going 11.
Mm-hmm.
You think it's higher or lower, Kim?
Mm-hmm. New York is closer to Paris than California. I'm going to say lower.
You're going lower.
Yeah.
I'd like to think that everybody across America now is going, let me see this, the area. Everybody's trying to figure it out. You're going to go 11. I'm saying 12, just off the top of my head, 12, but you're going lower than 11. The actual number of numbers you would have to dial to reach Paris is 14. It isn't lower, it's higher. It is higher, so Jack, 14 numbers, that's a lot to remember. Here you are, Jack. Take a look at your base card, sir. Tell me what you want. A king.
I'll go lower, Bill. Go lower
than a king. A jack.
Lower, Bill.
Lower than a jack. We've got a 10.
Lower, Bill.
He goes on. Lower than a 10, a 2.
Higher, Bill. Higher, Bill.
This man will waste any time. From Hot Springs, Arkansas, for game number one, Tahiti. Tahiti. Susanna comes out, puts Tahiti on your side of the board. Let's replace that card. We're going higher than a 2.
Higher, Bill.
Again, for game number one. There it is.
I've never
had it that quickly. Stick around. We'll be right back with game number two right after this.
We give you the letters, you supply the words on Blockbusters. After that, fast forward for fun with Family Feud and your daily dose of delirium on Match Game. Stay tuned.
We are out of time. Goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
They're sharp. They're smooth. To them, life's just one big game. They're Rayburn's 11, Woolery, Eubanks, Hall, Ludden, Dawson, Perry, Combs, Conby, Tamarkin, Trebek, and Rayburn, the ringleader. Daytime is playtime. Rayburn's 11, tomorrow starting at 9, 8 central on GSN.